The Memphis native died last night when a gunfight broke out at Tennessee State University. Cameron was caught in the crossfire. 5 months later, no arrests have been made.
His mother, Stacy Payne, not only wants answers for her family, but she doesn't want any other families to go through the same heartache. How are you, Stacy?
I'm okay this morning. How are you all doing?
Great.
Doing well. You described Cameron's death like as if your heart had been stomped on by an elephant. Explain those feelings again.
Right. That was with the interview with Ms. Zanetta Lowe, because it's something that I never expected as a mother. You don't expect to bury your son. Mm-hmm. So just thinking about the way that I could describe my pain, that's what it felt like. My heart was just really just hurt.
So you're hosting a rally to try to get word out. Who do you most want to reach?
I want to reach everybody, our youth, their parents, everyone here in our city. The rally is taking place this Saturday, Silence the Violence, at the place of the Alpine and Olivet Fellowship, which is located on Knight Arnold. And our goal is just to educate our youth, to bring the city together, and let's do something about all the senseless violence that's going on.
You hear so much, you read so much, you watch so much on the news these days when it comes to violence, when it comes to crime. Spain, do you think anybody will listen? What's your hope?
My hope and prayer is that somebody will listen. There's been so much going on here in our city, and everybody's talking about, well, we need to do something. Well, let's do something. Let's get out here and let's silence the violence.
What does a rally do, though? Who do you, I mean, because the people who are committing murders like that of your son, they aren't going to be at the rally. Do you want police officers to come? I mean, they're already working the streets. How can this kind of thing really help the message?
Well, it is our hope that some of the people who have guns, it is our hope that they will come. We have a wide variety of speakers coming to speak to our audience. We have I Am RJ Groove and the Kingdom Party Radio. A group of gospel rap artists. We know that a lot
so
of our young
music.
We do. We have a lot of things that will appeal to many people. So we're just hoping that they will see us, see the balloon, see the crowd, and come on in and hear what we have to say.
Tell us, though, also kind of going back to earlier when we were talking about Cameron, who was he?
He was my oldest son. He was 19 years old. He was vibrant, full of life. There is no perfect child. You know, I know nobody can say that, but he was a good son and I loved him. Right. Had a lot of life.
And the shooting, of course, which happened in Nashville, he was just in a group. So I think your point is that anyone standing by, a bystander in a situation, can become victim. Do we need to get more guns off the street? What do we need to do?
We definitely need to educate our youth and just everyone on the importance of gun violence prevention and just how it can be devastating to the families.
Yeah. One decision by them can absolutely trash an entire family.
Right.
So stop and think.
Right. Yeah. Right.
Because that pain can not only be felt by your family, but by an entire community.
But just by anybody. I mean, research shows that 89 people die per day of gun violence, and that's just not in schools. I mean, everywhere. We see it in our city. And you know, as citizens, we have the responsibility, and what I mean by that, we have the ability to respond and take a stand.
To stand up against it.
Well, well, hopefully that's what people will listen and come out for the rally. Thank you for your time.
Doors open at 12:30 on Saturday.
Thank you. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.
Stay right here. All right, a crime alert at a Mid-South elementary school. Two young